Hello friends, welcome to KT Research Guidance Bureau. Myself, Dr. Kumudini R. Thakur, founder member of the Bureau, would like to say few words for the Bureau. This Bureau is very helpful to all research students, those who are interested to do their research work. It will provide you complete guideline about your research work. Plus, those who are interested to do their master degree courses. This Bureau gives complete knowledge about various subjects related to master degree. Not only this, those who are interested to clear their NET, SLET or any other competitive exams, this Bureau provides them A to Z information for that. Not only this, those who are not included in any of the category but interested to enhance the knowledge, this Bureau is very helpful to them and they can update themselves and can increase the knowledge. So my humble request to you that please subscribe the Bureau, give your comments and favor for the Bureau. Last time, I gave you the idea about planning. Today, I would like to extend that one for strategic planning. Why? Because nowadays, strategic planning is the main thing. So, let's try to understand simple meaning of strategic planning. Strategic planning is the art of formulating business strategies, implementing them, and evaluating their impact on organizational objectives. So, this is one of the simple definitions of strategic planning. In other words, strategic planning is an organizational process of defining its strategy or direction and making decisions on allocating its resources to pursue this strategy. It covers 2-3 more points. In another way, we can say that in order to determine the direction of the organization, it is necessary to understand its current position and the possible avenues through which it can pursue a particular course of action. So, when you want to achieve something, that time you have to keep in mind available resources and how you can pursue or how you can fulfill your objectives with these resources that you have to plan out. And that is the strategy to fulfill that objective. In another time or for the other objective, your strategy may vary from this strategy. So, generally, strategic planning deals with at least one of the three key questions. Among them, first one is, what do we do? This is the first and foremost question. Second one is, for whom do we do it? For whom? For the human resources, for the environment, or for any new technology? And third question is, how do we excel? How you can execute it? So, these three basic questions you have to keep in mind, and afterwards you have to design your strategy. When you want to design your strategy, that time some basic elements or main thing you have to keep in mind and you have to develop it. Among them, first one is vision. Your vision must be clear. So, outline what the organization wants to be or how it wants the world in which it operates to be. So, first define and clear your vision. After that, your mission. That defines the fundamental purpose of an organization, briefly describing why it exists and what it does to achieve its vision. So, you want to achieve, your vision is clear and you want to achieve it. For that, you have to do something that you have to clear. Now, keep in mind, there is one sort of, we can say, confusion. What comes first, vision or mission? It is not like first and second, but both you have to clear, and clear the idea about vision and mission. And generally we speak vision and mission, not mission and vision. That's why first is vision and second one is mission. Third one is values. Beliefs that are shared among the stakeholders of an organization. What the organization believes. What are the values of the organization that you have to share with all stakeholders and design your strategy, means the art of the general, a combination of the goals for which firm is striving and the means by which it is seeking to get there. So, when you talk about strategic planning, that time all these four basic things you have to clear. And if you are clear, then 50% of the success you will get automatically, because you have clear idea about it. This is the real time to understand the difference between business plan and strategic plan. Without business plan, none of the business can succeed. Same is the case for the strategy. Without strategy, how can you achieve your goals? So, let's clear the difference between these two terminologies. First one is about the meaning. So far as business plan is concerned, it is a document that summarize the operational and financial objectives of a business. Operational, you consider sales, marketing, every types of operations, means it summarizes both operational and financial objectives of a business. And so far as strategic plan is concerned, it is the art of formulating business strategies, implementing them, and evaluating their impact on organizational objectives. Whether with this strategy you are able to catch organizational objectives or not. Second thing is about answer of the question. When you do your business plan, that time first is, what do I want to do? Your business plan replies this question, while your strategic plan, how will I do it, replies this question. Then, if you want to design a business plan, you need more data, more figures, while in strategic plan, comparatively with less data, you can develop your strategy. So far as purpose is concerned, in business plan, what is the purpose? To define where you want to take your business, and in strategic plan, to achieve your decided goals. So, this is the purpose of business plan and strategic plan. And so far as usefulness is concerned, business plan is generally for new business. When you want to start a new business, you need business plan. While strategic planning is for both, for the new business as well as for running business. It doesn't mean that afterwards, once you plan your business, then you don't need planning, you need. But generally, it is required at the initial stage. And strategic planning, it requires for each and every objective and each and every stage, because you want to get success for your business, that you have to keep in mind. Now, you want to develop a strategic plan. Strategic planning is a process. In a sequence, you have to develop it. Among them, first one is mission. Your mission must be clear. Afterwards, your objectives. What are your objectives? Then, to fulfill that objectives, you have to work. For that, you have to analyze situation. It is known as situation analysis. In this situation, are you able to fulfill your objectives? If answer is yes, then design or formulate your strategy, means strategy formulation. Formulate your strategy. When you formulated the strategy, then only formulation can't give you any fruit. You have to implement it. So, after formulating, you have to implement it. Right now, these farmers, they are agitating. So they also develop their strategy for that. Their intentions are different and they are showing in a different manner. But with the passage of time, our government and people are able to understand their strategy and their objectives. So today, scenario is little bit different. That is, and government took some actions. So their formulation was very clear on their part. They implemented also. But this government is little bit more stronger and intelligent. So they are unable to fulfill their objectives, and it is good for our economy. And after implementation, or at the time of implementation, you have to control. In control means, first you formulate the strategy, then you implemented the strategy. When you are doing your work, that time you have to compare that with your actual budgeted work or your formulation. And if there is a negative gap, then you have to bridge it. So that is the control. So these are the common steps for strategic planning. So when you design your strategy, that time keep in mind. First question comes in your mind: what are the benefits of strategic planning? We have business planning. But see, if your strategic planning is perfect, then you can understand purpose of the organization. And as per the purpose, objective of the organization, the total community which is related to the organization, they will work in the same direction. So that organization can fulfill their criteria or their objectives. Second thing is, if your strategic planning is perfect, you can communicate this strategy to your subordinates or your employees so that they can understand what is the organization, how this organization wants to work, and accordingly they will try to adjust. Then main thing is, if you include your subordinate to design the strategy, they will feel that I am not simply an employee of the organization, I am also an owner of the company. It is my responsibility. So they will work nicely, and you can increase the efficiency of your employee. Then if you want to establish a proper mechanism in your organization, then you can implement it so that each and every person can understand the total scenario. Not only this, if there is a gap of communication or ideology or belief, strategic planning helps to narrow down the gap or to absorb it completely. Then, as I told you, that if you involve everyone, it increases the efficiency, profitability, and with the stipulated time period, you can fulfill your organization's objectives very nicely. So this is the brief idea about strategic planning. I hope you followed it. And keep in mind, those who are interested to do their research work, strategic planning is one of the best area. Suppose you want to do your research work on Surat Municipal Corporation, then you can consider it and you can complete your research work. So, in the present situation, strategic planning is one of the most important area for your research. Hope you enjoyed the session, and please don't forget to subscribe the channel, give your comments and favor for the Bureau. Thank you very much. So nice of you.